Indie Girl, do you enjoy talking about Scientology? Wouldn't an ex-Scientologist at some point just get tired of the subject and want to move on and focus on other things of interest? Don't get me wrong, I love watching your videos and think what you do is of great value, but aren't you bored of it yet? It's been an interesting experience putting myself out here and talking about Scientology as much as I have. I realized the other day I've got over 300 videos, most of them having to do with Scientology. And believe me, when I started this, I had no idea or intention of putting out that much content about this subject, but it's been of such interest to people, and there have been so many things to talk about with it, from its recruitment to its sales to the, you know, the hard sell and all that, the abuses of the organization and all the details of how the organization works. And people just seem to be endlessly fascinated by this, which is why I kind of keep putting it out there. And they also seem to be getting helped by my channel, which is the other reason why I keep doing this, talking about this subject. You've seen on my channel, if you've been paying attention for any length of time, that I have been expanding the subject matter and content of my channel on purpose because I, you know, this isn't a thing that I will be able to talk about forever. There is a finite number of things to say about the subject of Scientology, but I haven't hit that point yet. Sometimes I get a little bored with it, but I also know that I'm helping people. And I know that because they tell me that I am. Not just, wow, Chris, this was really interesting or informative, but I'm talking about emails and private communications I get from people that let me know that they were staff members or they were Scientologists and they saw my stuff or read my book, and as a result, they have gotten out and escaped. I am very happy about that. That was the first thing that I wanted to accomplish with this channel. And if I'm still accomplishing it, then I feel a little bit of an obligation to continue with it in that regard. But I also, you know, like I said, have been expanding the content out on different but related fields and some things that aren't related at all, but are of very much of an interest to me. You know, some of the things on my podcast and some of the videos on critical thinking, which I think are directly related, but some people might not make the connection right away between Scientology stuff and critical thinking stuff, but to me, they're, you know, hand in glove. So I'm gonna, you know, kind of keep going at this. And like I said, sometimes I'm, you know, kind of bored of it and sometimes I'm not. So I guess, like everybody else, I think it depends on the, you know, how my day is going and how inspired I get about something that maybe I've recalled about the topic or some, you know, part of it that hasn't been particularly talked about before. Like the video I made recently about Scientology's, I think I called it the Scientology's totally insane recruitment methods or something like that. You know, nobody's really talked about that before. And I wrote an article about it a long time ago, and then I made a video about it because I wanted to talk about it in more detail. And of course, you know, the only people who are giving me a hard time about that are the people who actually believe in conspiracy theories. Well, okay, I guess, sorry guys, but you know, that's what Scientology uses to recruit people. So, yeah, not cool. So anyway, I'm just kind of going on here, but that's sort of my feelings about the whole thing. And I think that it will continue for a while as I get the rest of the big ticket items that I still have on my agenda to get done. I'll get those things done, and then we'll see, you know, we'll see where we go with this.